prior to 2017, no pangolin poacher served any jail term. The common fine was negligible. It's probably less than $100 US. To clamp down and to lock everybody up is going to be quite problematic because it is hugely culturally acceptable. We need to make it globally available out there that this animal is going to disappear from your culture, and that is a massive thing. Well, let me give you an example of the trade I've recorded leaving the African continent this year alone, which is around about 68.8 tons of African pangolin scales. And that, remember, is just what we've recorded, which is probably around 10% of the actual trade. This is an extreme impact. I don't think their populations can sustain this onslaught for the next 2 to 3 decades. The pangolin is an ancient mammal, evolutionary speaking, 85 million years. It's the only mammal covered in hard keratinous overlapping scales. They're completely edentate. They can't even open their mouth. They've got a tongue almost as long as their body. They're very closely related, evolutionarily speaking, to the carnivora, in particular cats. Its physiology is quite unique to any other animal, but because it's so unique and that it's covered in these hard overlapping scales made out of keratin, that's its downfall. That's what it makes it so sought after. Pangolins, both in Asia, in particular Vietnam, and in Africa, have been used as bushmeat and regarded as a delicacy for many thousands of years. But more importantly, both in Africa and Asia, pangolins are used culturally as traditional pharmacopoeia or traditional medicine, if you want to call it that. And that also dates back many, many thousands of years. And this is its great prize, and this is its great downfall, is the harvest of its scales ground into powder and added as a remedy, both traditional African and traditional Asian medicines.
There's no medicinal value to scales. It's like biting your own nails. They're the same material as rhino horn, so it has no medicinal value whatsoever.
We work in the Gulf of Guinea and Ghana and Sierra Leone, so our organization is involved intensely in Africa and in Africa's pangolins, but more intensely in South Africa in reversing the illegal trade in the Temis ground pangolin. We do have legal sting operations where we pose as buyers and we pull pangolins out of the trade and arrest poachers. We work very closely with the COVID police units, the stock theft units also working as endangered species units, the Department of Environmental Affairs, the Environmental Management Inspectorate, the National Prosecuting Authority, all collectively working together to combat this trade.
We are very much involved with police and law enforcement. So when they are called about a sting or a pangolin in the trade, the African Pangolin Working Group goes in, Ray Janssen, and they confiscate the pangolin. And after all the processes with the police, the pangolin comes here for treatment and rehabilitation. Most of them are very compromised. They haven't had food for about 7 to 10 days or water. Some of them have been closed in a bag or in a drum, sitting in their own urine and feces for weeks. They often have pneumonia, they have wounds, they need drips, they need antibiotics and quite intensive care. This little girl is called Titi. She was intercepted near the Zimbabwe border. We don't know where her mom is. She's supposed to be still with her mom. She's only 1.5 kilos. She's very small, still very young, probably about 2 months old only. So she came to us and, it's a yawn. She came to us and we have to hand raise her now, give her milk, take her out walking until she's old enough so we can release her back into the wild. The most difficult thing about studying pangolins is they are so difficult to find. You can't get in a helicopter and fly around and see one like you hit rhino and elephant. And they're so secretive, they only come out at night, they're very quiet. Nobody really knew about them until they were poached at this level because they were just going on with their lives as normal. And now suddenly we have to find ways to study something that hides in a hole during the day and makes no noise at night, so it's difficult.
Since we've been campaigning and been in the courts and providing testimony in aggravation sentencing since 2017, the latest sentence we got was 8 years in jail. The maximum sentence for a pangolin poacher in this country is 10 years in jail in collaboration or without a fine of 10 million South African rands.
You can't save something that you don't know exists. They're not just a scaly, hard thing, they're a mammal. and they have a personality. From the first time I've met one, we all say it's like a bewitching. You see them for the first time and you just fall in love. You can't help.
Even though you haven't seen one, even though you're not aware of one, it doesn't mean you shouldn't care about this wonderful, mystical and charismatic mammal that's disappearing very rapidly. The best the public can do globally out there all over the world is spread the word, spread the message, spread the love. That's the very best thing you can do. We need to send out the love for this animal all over the world. And we need to, like, we embrace our pop icons, we need to embrace these things just as heavily, just as strongly, and with the same amount of emotion.